نائلة عايش, a human rights activist and an outspoken voice on issues of women and peace, was born in Jerusalem to a refugee family known for its liberal views and lifestyle. After finishing her high school in Ramallah, Naila got a scholarship to study science in Bulgaria. That was the first challenge Naila had to face, being a Palestinian young woman eager to get education outside her country and on her own. In Bulgaria, Naila had to face another challenge, but this time she faced it with Jamal Zakout, a young man from Gaza. They worked together to promote the Palestinian legitimate case. Naila and Jamal decided to get married, a thing that was not easy considering the different social backgrounds they both came from. The young couple finally got married in Ramallah and moved to live in Gaza. Shortly after their marriage, the new couple had their share of struggle, being Palestinians under occupation. Naila, newly pregnant at the time, was arrested by the Israeli occupation forces. The harsh treatment and torture she went through made her lose her baby. Palestinian, Israeli and international human rights activists adopted Naila's case and prepared an appeal signed by 100 people. These efforts resulted in Naila's release after spending 36 days in detention. It was not long before Naila had to cope with a new hard situation. It was the first Palestinian intifada, and Jamal had his active role as a community leader. Expectedly, Jamal was detained, and Naila was pregnant at that time. It was so emotionally hard for Naila to give birth away from her family and her husband. Naila and her young baby boy, Majd, could not enjoy the company of Jamal, not just because of his detention, but because shortly afterwards, Jamal was exiled. Naila, along with several human rights organizations and activists, organized a big campaign calling for stopping the Israeli collective punishment presented in deportation. Majd was 6 months old when Naila had to face detention again, this time with a young baby. They were both put under the so-called administrative detention, based on no defined charges. The young baby had his first words and steps in a prison cell. It was extremely heart-aching hearing him saying "Dad," while he had never actually met his dad before. Naila and Majd's extraordinary humanitarian story got numerous support worldwide. A group of activists called themselves Naila Group kept struggling until they succeeded in releasing the two. Naila and her group of supporters kept fighting to enable her to leave the country in order to meet with her husband. Majd finally met his father for the first time when he was 2 years old. The small family lived in exile for 4 years, where they had their second child, a baby girl, Raghd. Naila and Jamal never gave up until a solution was found to the problem of deported people, and they managed at last to get back to Gaza in 1994. In 1996, Naila, believing in women's rights and roles, took the mission of leading the Women's Affairs Center in Gaza, WAC. WAC seeks to promote women's rights and gender equality within Palestinian society, and to develop the necessary tools to empower women. To date, WAC is still considered as one of the most successful organizations, not only in Gaza, but also in Palestine. Naila's difficult experience inspired her to share in several humanitarian activities. She has been actively involved in a number of international and local organizations advocating peace, conflict resolution, women empowerment, family law, and other issues related to human rights. Naila, among other activities, is a member of the International Women Commission and the International Campaign to Break the Siege on Gaza. After the Palestinian internal fighting in June 2007, the small family moved to Ramallah. Naila now has to face the hard procedures at Erez checkpoint weekly. She comes to WAC's office during the work days and then back to join her family on the weekends. Naila's life is not any less easier now. Naila sees herself as a Palestinian woman who wishes to live in an independent nation, embraced by peace and justice. A mother who, like any other mother, wants to raise her children in an environment of love and peace. She is a Palestinian woman with a story that is worth telling.